can state with conviction that our country has turned the corner. Liberia is no longer a place of conflict, war, and deprivation. We are no longer the country our citizens want to run away from, our international partners pitied, and our neighbors feared. We have earned our rightful place as a beacon of democracy.
The good thing is, thanks to all of the partners, thanks to our prayers are answered, thanks to all the people who came together every work, and people who said no to violence and yes to peace, that made a difference in Liberia.
Our UN body is very helpful to us because we have got a lot of experts. Police personnel, when it comes to sexual and gender-based violence issues, we have brought in officer, meaning female officer, come to us and they help us a lot. They give us advices. We use their expertise in our investigation when it comes to sexual and gender-based violence. So we have brought in a lot of good guys from the UN for our section.
Cooperation with my other colleagues and counterparts, we all together have made, I think, very good job here.
The advice which has been provided alongside the training, capacity building, capacity development, is that there was no such huge violence during the preparation to the election.
The UN stood with us. The UN peacekeeping mission have ensured unbroken peace within our borders for more than a decade.
The world here. So when the women are forming a vital part of this formation, the UNMIL, so I think there should be a strong support to them in the form of medical facility.
I never had the slackest thought of being a police officer, but when I came in the police station, I saw things. I saw how females are working, and I felt prompted that I can do more. That's how I got motivated. They are good men. They are good male officers, and they are also good female officers. All depends on you knowing your potential. All depends on knowing what you are, what you are made of, and what you can do.
This is what has been our major achievement as UNMIL, so that the LNP and other security sectors of Liberia can stand on their own and policy the nation as they are required to do. So far from what I have seen, they are able to stand on their own.
I don't think that they need UNMIL more than this, so actually I'm very happy to live here because they have all maladies. Working with others, working with our countries, and working for their certain field. So I think it's time to go back to our countries after closing this mission.
We The UN mission in Liberia is going to be closed in a short time, and that's why the project itself is called a quick impact project. The implementation aspect is quick to be able to meet up with the time, but the impact is what is left with them for a longer time.
The UN mission in Liberia financed a quick impact project as part of a larger concept of boosting urban agriculture in Liberia and creating employment, sustainable employment for many of our unemployed youth.
We believe OMI is actually one of those international institutions. And one of the key arms of OMI is the issue of the environment that we talk about, climate change. And we know it's something that's being pushed all around the world. So I see OMI coming to our institution or working with our institution to be able to create a better environment and also create opportunities for young people.
OMI has done a lot in Liberia. And this is just an addition of what they have been doing. Liberians have been able to go to bed and wake up in the last 15 years very peacefully. That alone surpassed everything.
It is true that ONMIL is now in the final chapter and ONMIL is closing, but through projects like this, there are new openings that are being made possible for Liberians to take further. And the continued United Nations presence in the country will be working exactly on that.
Apart from just delivering what I had, or together with our friends here, have also learned how to respect people's opinions, how to develop a new idea that comes through, and how to integrate it within the required specifics. So this experience is not just for here, but also back for my home.
I will take a lot of knowledge back home as well, from my colleagues, from Liberia, from Liberian people and from the police here.
It's a great experience. You get friends from all over the world, and you bring people back into heart when you're going home.
This was a memorable time for me here, not only with my own colleagues here, my unit, the interaction that I had with the local people. Definitely, I'm going to cherish it for my life.
We make a lot of emphasis on promoting peace, national reconciliation. Much of our programming has harped on, getting Liberians reconciled among themselves, being tolerant of each other's views, burying the hatchet after years of war, and joining what really has been one of the catchphrases around, Mama Liberia is all we have. Even though the UN mission is finally closing shop, the UN family stays by. The UN country team is still going to be around and be supportive of Liberia's struggles in the days ahead.
I would like to tell the UN that Liberia is grateful. We are so much grateful for their help. They have helped us reach this far, and we promised that we're going to hold up to what we've learned from them and maintain the peace and stability of this country. This is all we have, Liberia.
Liberia today still faces challenges, but it's a peaceful country. It's a country that has a democratic institution, and it's a country that can be now on its way to development.
Yes, we've made significant progress, and it is successful because every Liberian, I think, has acknowledged the need that we have to shoulder this shared responsibility. We do it together. It's not one person's challenge or one group of people or one political party, but every Liberian, with all hands on deck, we've got to do this together to make sure it succeeds.